In this video, we are going to see how to symbolically manipulate a matrix using symbolic Python or Sympy programming to get reduced row echelon form for our matrix. So I am at the website live.sympy.org. So this is the computer program Sympy running on the Google App Engine. It's free. It's just a regular Python shell. So SymPy is symbolic manipulation of mathematical expressions, and we can use SymPy without any knowledge of programming here. So we first want to enter our matrix, so I'm going to use the matrix that we entered in our previous example. So in the SymPy, you come down on the left to the prompt here with the three arrows, and I am going to call my matrix M. You can use any letter you like, but M is pretty easy here. And the code then to say is matrix with a capital M. And then in parentheses, I'm going to enter the matrix values. So I need to start with a square bracket. And then for each row, I enter those values within another square bracket. So our first row was 6, 4, 3, 8. So those go within one square bracket. And then I put a comma here for my next row. So those values were 3, 2, 1, 3. Close off that square bracket, put a comma, start on our third row. Those values were 1, 1, 1, and 2. And then I gotta close off double square brackets. And remember also to close off my parentheses here. This matrix terminology is what's known as a function in programming. So our code is telling SymPy to create a matrix with these parameters. So if we hit enter, that should enter our matrix. If I type M and hit enter, it gives me a visual of my matrix, so I can check to make sure that was the matrix that we were working with. So now I want to find reduced row echelon. So to do that, I'll call this R for a name for that object. So I'm going to say R equals, and then I need to say M dot RREF, that's the code for reduced row echelon form, and then I put parentheses, and then the last thing I'm going to do is in my brackets put a zero in here and hit enter. And then if I type R here, I get my output of my matrix in reduced row echelon form. And this is exactly what we kind of painstakingly tried to work through in the video using arithmetic calculations. So we can see it is much nicer to let technology do the calculations for us. If you didn't enter the zero in our code, say we just said, give me reduced row echelon form with the parentheses, you get two outputs. So the first entry is the reduced row echelon form of the matrix, and then the second values are the pivot columns. So it tells us the locations of the pivot columns. So we will just do the reduced row echelon form with the parentheses and then put the zero in there. That zero just gives us this first column of the output. So you do not need to do reduced row echelon form by hand. Go ahead and rely on SymPy here at live.sympy.org. And you are welcome to use other technology as well, but SymPy is free and pretty easy to get to.